Nidhi.
Yes.
What's your name, please? Name, your name.
My name, Nuri.
Nuri, if you want something with all your heart, huh?
I want it.
Would you want it right now or would you want it tomorrow?
I want it right now.
If you want it right now, would you adopt a path?
No.
Huh? Is not sadhana a path? If I want something right now, would I adopt a method or would I just stand up and with all the energy in every single cell of my body cry out, I want it right now?
I do, but I also see myself sometimes identifying with certain things. I see the conditioning, and sometimes grace has brought me to see certain aspects of my life, and I see how grace is working in different aspects of my life, and all is being purified and clean.
First of all, it is good that you are talking of grace, but please never claim that you can see how grace is working.
Something.
Grace by definition can only be thanked, never really concluded or analyzed. One can never understand the ways of grace.
I call it grace.
Yes, yes. One can only be full of gratitude towards it.
Yes.
Huh? Grace and gratefulness. One can never know how it works. One never knows why you are in front of somebody right now. One never knows why you are not doing something right now. So, and whenever you say that is not happening, you must remember that is more than eager to happen at all points in time and space. That is absolutely willing to happen. You have to find out how you are blocking it. There must be something that you hold as dear, or there must be something that you are afraid of. It will happen. It is happening right now. Allow it. Allow it. Allowed? Happened. Done.
There's still something here. I can feel the energy is not completely relaxed.
You know,
estimates that this energy is.
Kabir, the wonderful saint poet, has said that truth comes and sits only on the cleanest, purest, highest seat, the throne reserved for it. If in that space something else or somebody else is there, then the truth refuses to come. Please clear off the area. Only the Lord should be allowed there, nobody else. Surely there is something, some idea, some concern, some person, something there that is occupying the place of truth. Truth will not come if you have other priorities. Everything else must hold second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 20th priority. First priority must belong to the truth, and then it comes.
I want to believe that I am letting go, but probably on a very subtle level.
Okay, suppose there are 10 things in a room and you want to clear that room. You want to let go of things. You want to clear that room. So what will you do? What will you do with those 10 things? One thing kept out, the next thing kept out, two things, three things, five things, ultimately 10 things. And still the truth is not entering. The truth is still not entering that room, saying that no, the room is still not clear. Something is still there. What is still there? Yourself. So when you say that you are trying to clear things, maybe you are not trying to clear away yourself. After 10 things have been put out, you must also take yourself out of that room. If you remain there, even then, there is a problem. But that is the last thing to say. Usually we remain along with a lot of our accessories.
So how do you clean all this?
When they are seen as stinking and rotten.
So observing them.
Yeah. It's a dirty.
But that's a judgment. That's the evil game.
That's a fact. That's a fact. Is your hurt a judgment? Are your tears a judgment? Is the daily suffering a judgment? Is the tension and irritation and jealousy and possessiveness a judgment? Yes. When you see that this is what is coming to me out of all these things, then you say, ah, who wants them? Who wants them? If all that this relationship can give me is daily chaos, who wants it? Huh? Now it is gone. You haven't dropped it. It's gone. The attraction is no more. Gone.